How can you do that? How can you ensure you're looking fresh? You need to put on your good outfit, the outfit that you keep that make you feel good. You need to put your hair together, your face and your makeup together. Now, when I talk about looking fresh, it should also be your attitude that should reflect through the camera, right? Because personally, we're not meeting. Everything is virtual. So even through the camera, people should be able to make out that you're excited to be here. So that's your body language and how you're appearing, your expression, how you dress yourself up and how you're showcasing yourself. Next thing is style your hair. By styling, I don't mean aapko har baar straighten karna hai ya curl karne hai apne baal. Nahin. But you have to look put together. You should look cohesive. You should look harmonious. Aisa nahi ki, you know, your hair is all around the place. Or even if you're tying your hair, it should be neat. It should be tied neatly in a ponytail. Or if you're leaving it, just make sure it's neat. That's all. You don't have to do too much. Next thing is wear your accessories. Aapko dikh raha hai, maine kuch accessories pehne hain. Something, if you can make out. Yeah, I can see a few nods. I'm wearing a necklace, I'm wearing earrings, I'm wearing few rings. Ye important kyun hai? Kyunki hamara skin contrast with the clothes that we're wearing, right? So when there is a negative space, attention goes straight there. So imagine ye necklace nahi hota, this is too much skin showing, it's too much negative space, open space bahut hai, jiski wajah se your attention is going to be drawn here. So ensure that you're looking perfectly well put together. Jitna aap otherwise styling karte, every time you move out of the house, hum thoda styling karte, we wear good earrings, we wear a necklace. Same way you have to appear for your virtual sessions as well. And not just virtual sessions, even when you take videos about yourself, when you take a photograph of yourself that you're going to put up on social media, try and look your best version, right? Because the more better you look, the more better you're going to feel about yourself. And that's going to reflect. Next thing is, like I've already discussed, the idea here is to look presentable and well put together. Cohesive lagna chahiye, harmonious lagna chahiye. Nothing should be distracting. You know, if your hair is not proper or your t-shirt is a very normal one, it's a little dull, you're not going to look your best. So these are a few things that you must keep in mind. Next is eye contact and body language. It's imperative. It's so important that you give eye contact to the people you're speaking to, right? And how do you do that? Virtual setups, mein you have to look in the camera. But you can't do this. अगर मैं ऐसी करती होगी, आप लोग डर जाओगे. बोलोगे ये क्या हो रहा है, right? So occasionally look in the camera, nod a little, right? That will show the trainer and everybody present that you're attentive and you're liking how the session is going. You're understanding and you're comprehending everything. So maintain eye contact. अगर आप कोई सवाल किसी को पूछते हैं, उनको या तो सर मैम करके बोले या फिर उनका नाम लेके उनको एड्रेस करे. दैट्स हाउ यू एड्रेस एंड यू हैव टू लुक इन द कैमरा व्हाइल स्पीकिंग टू देम, राइट? विदाउट, इमेजिन दिस, अगर मैं आपसे बात कर रही हूँ, आपको एक ट्रेनिंग दे रही हूँ, लेकिन मैं देख ही नहीं रही. इफ आई एम लुकिंग हियर कि आपको ये करना है, आप सोच रहे होंगे कहाँ देख रही है. यू नो, शी शुड लुक हियर. यू शुड ऑलवेज लुक एट योर ऑडियंस, ऑलवेज लुक एट द पर्सन दैट यू आर एड्रेसिंग. नेक्स्ट इज यू हैव टू ओकेजनली नॉड. In virtual setups, it's very difficult to know what is going on in your mind, right? Physically, it's very easy. You can read somebody's body language very easily. But virtually, you have to make that slight effort. Occasionally, not all the time. Har time ye aise nahi karna hai. Occasionally nod, so that you're giving a feedback to everybody present that you get what's happening, you like what's happening, and you're happy to be here. Third thing is be mindful of your thoughts. कई बार क्या होता है, हम हमारे थॉट्स में ड्रिफ्ट हो जाते हैं. इसके बाद ये करना है, कल ये करना है, अरे सबमिट करना बाकी है, रिपोर्ट बनाना है. अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स आर गोइंग ऑन इन आवर माइंड एंड हमें रियलाइज भी नहीं होता हमारा एक्सप्रेशन कब इंटरेस्टेड से ऐसे हो जाता है. यू ऑलरेडी लॉस्ट इन योर थॉट्स. सो बी माइंडफुल एंड ट्राई एंड बी प्रेजेंट इन द सेशन. क्योंकि लॉस सिर्फ आपका ही है. इफ यू गोना गेट कैरिड अवे, it's only your loss and nobody should go through that, right? Next is don't appear blank or disinterested. That is really something you must work on. Everybody must work on. Because when you appear blank or disinterested, it's going to look like this. Imagine, kariye main aapse aise baat kar rahi hu, आधा घंटा मैं आपसे ऐसी बात कर रही हूँ कि आपको आई कॉन्टैक्ट मेंटेन करना है, ओकेजनली नॉट करना है. इट्स रियली डिफिकल्ट टू कनेक्ट विद दैट पर्सन, राइट? सो एनश्योर दैट यू आर लुकिंग इंटरेस्टेड अ लिटिल, यू नो, your body language and the way you're expressing your expressions on your face, everything shows a little attentiveness. Next is, don't use too many gestures. It's distracting. So sometimes when we unmute ourselves and we start talking, hame realize nahi hota hum aise baat kar rahe. So actually I had a question and I had to say this, and this, what is happening is your gestures are all over the place. It's distracting from what you're saying. So attention उन gestures पे जा रहा है और आप पे कम. So ensure that you're not using too many gestures. Another thing that you have to note is really, really important. Don't slouch or hunch when you're sitting for these training sessions or you're sitting in front of the camera. क्योंकि the minute you do this, you're making yourself smaller, and that's coming across like you're low on confidence. It's coming across. It may not be true. Lekin it's coming across like you're low on confidence, low on energy, right? So this slouching is an absolutely a no, a big no. So what you have to do is you have to square your shoulders, hold your chin up, right? Sit upright. Your back should be straight. Because the minute you do this, it's going to feel like your attitude is also going to be a little too relaxed. So ensure that your body language is portraying the correct posture. Next is styling. Jitna zaruri hai physically dress karna, utna hi zaruri hai virtually settings mein dress up karna. Because the way you dress up is the way you're going to feel and think about yourself, right? Do we want to feel average? Do you want to feel casual, unmotivated? No, right? We all want to be motivated. We all want to be productive and attentive. So you have to look that part also. So wear something. Wear a nice top. Jo aap bahar jaane ke liye pehnoge, wahi aapko camera ke samne bhi pehenna hai. Something nice, right? And beware of your neckline. Ensure that you're not wearing something that's really making you feel uncomfortable and hence making others feel uncomfortable. So your preferred necklines are your U-neck, your V-neck, turtle neck, boat neck. These are safe necklines. What will happen is, agar aap khud uncomfortable hai, you'll keep fidgeting. Aap constantly ye karte rahenge, and because you're uncomfortable, wo aapke face pe dikhega, and then the others will notice, and then somebody will ask you, are you okay? So cut that short. Wear something that you are absolutely comfortable and confident in. Next is, avoid deep necks and strappy tops. Yahan pe maine avoid likha hai, ye nahi kaha hai ki don't wear them. If you're comfortable, please go ahead, because our clothing is how we express ourselves. Having said that, when you're wearing something really deep or you're wearing a strappy top and you're going to constantly be fidgeting with it, it's going to come across like you're feeling uncomfortable, right? So stay in what you like, do what you like, wear what you like, but don't look uncomfortable. Next is, avoid extremely busy prints. It disrupts the eye movement. If you're wearing something that has too much of print, too many colors, usme letters bhi hai, pattern bhi hai, colors hai, so many things going on, what will happen is it will distract from you. Aapke face se attention hat ke aapne kya pehna hai us pe jayega, because our minds will run in the direction of trying to comprehend ki kya pehna hai, kaun sa design hai, what print is it, what color is it. Your mind will try to make sense of it, so it's disrupting. जब आप बात करोगे, इट विल टेक अवे फ्रॉम व्हाट यू आर सीइंग. सो ऑलवेज रिमेंबर, द फोकस शुड बी यू एंड नॉट व्हाट यू आर वेयरिंग. योर क्लोथ शुड मेक यू लुक गुड एंड फील गुड, बट यू शुड बी द फोकस, राइट? नेक्स्ट थिंग इज, अवॉइड वेयरिंग एक्सट्रीमली थिन फैब्रिक दैट आर सी थ्रू. ये मोस्टली वाइब्स के साथ होता है. इफ यू आर वेयरिंग अ वेरी थिन फैब्रिक एंड लाइट फॉल्स ऑन इट, सो यू कैन सी द कलर्स एंड यू कैन सी इट्स सी थ्रू, सो यू कैन सी स्किन, यू कैन सी द इनर्स. Lines dikhte, kabhi kabhi colors dikhte hain, and that's not the best way to portray yourself, right? Would you agree? So you have to ensure ki jab aap light colors ya koi bhi thin fabric in any other colors when you're wearing, you ensure that it's not too see-through. So try and go for thicker fabrics is what I mean to say. Next is, consider contrast and you use it to your advantage. What do I mean by contrast? Contrast word ka meaning hai light and dark ka difference. For example, mera background light hai and I'm wearing a darker color. So that the attention stays on me, so that I become the highlight. Same way, if you have a light background, go for a darker top. If you have a dark background, go for a lighter top, so that you stand out and you are the focus. Next thing is avoid black with dark background. क्यों? क्योंकि अगर आप dark background है, अगर आप black पहन रहे हो, you will merge with the background. और सिर्फ आपका face will float, right? Sirf your face will be visible and your hands will be visible. It will look like you're floating because everything is merged around. Because of our hair and the background and what we are wearing, everything is merged. So you're getting lost in that. So ensure that you don't do that. Use contrast to your advantage. Think of light and dark before you dress up and before you sit for a meeting. Next is avoid green tops with green screen. Every time you wear a green top, और अगर आप वर्चुअल बैकग्राउंड लगा रहे हो जो ग्रीन स्क्रीन पे बनती है तो देयर इज अ हाई चांस कि आपका टॉप बैकग्राउंड के साथ मर्ज हो जाएगा बिकॉज ग्रीन स्क्रीन आर बेसिकली दे आर एनिमेटिंग वट एवर बैकग्राउंड यू हैव राइट कॉन्स्टेंटली दे आर चेंजिंग इट वी यूजिंग द इंटरनेट टू कॉन्स्टेंटली एनिमेट दैट पार्ट सो दैट योर बैकग्राउंड इज हिडन एंड अ सर्टन अदर बैकग्राउंड इज विजिबल सो वेन यू आर वेयरिंग अ ग्रीन दैट रियली मैचेज दैट इट्स गोइंग टू मर्ज Again, your head will appear to float. Next thing is, the thing you have to remember is, how do news anchors do it? वो तो साल से करते आ रहे हैं, right? सिर्फ इतना पार्ट दिखाई देता है हमें टीवी में when we see them, when they are giving us the news, they're telling us what is happening in our country. Take cues from how they are dressed and how they present themselves. Next time you switch on the TV and you go to a news channel, think about it. How are they presenting themselves? Are they dressed up? Are they wearing makeup? Have they done their hair? Are they wearing accessories? Background kaisa hai? How are they dressed? Is there too much print, too much color? Take these notes next time you switch on and learn from that. How can you better your view? How can you better your screen? How you appear on these virtual platforms? Now we'll speak a little about background. Teen cheeze hai background ke andar. Wall, backdrop, distractions and movement. सबसे पहले आपको ध्यान देना है कि आपका बैकग्राउंड बहुत डिस्ट्रैक्टिंग ना हो सो इफ देर इज अ मेसी यूनिट और देर इज समथिंग देर टू मेनी थिंग्स इन द बैकग्राउंड इट्स गोइंग टू टेक अवे द अटेंशन फ्रॉम यू सेम कॉन्सेप्ट अगर आप कुछ डिस्ट्रैक्टिंग पहनो के अटेंशन कपड़ों पर जाएगा एंड आप पे नहीं सेम चीज है विद बैकग्राउंड इफ देर आर टू मेनी थिंग्स गोइंग ऑन People are going to notice the background. They'll be engrossed in noticing the background more than you. So ensure, go for a neutral background. Anything that is plain, let's just say a plain wall hai, white colored walls that we have, or a neutral painting, jisme zyada colors nahi hai, zyada textures nahi hai, that is a great background. Anything that does not capture too much attention. For example, in my background, there is a neutral colored wardrobe. So it's not catching too much attention. Attention still stays on me. Next thing is, what you can do is use the blurred background feature, which I'll just showcase right now. Can you all see the difference? So this is the virtual blurred background feature jo sare virtual meetings mein they give you the option use this option only as a last resort because when you are constantly going to use this blurred background feature what you are doing is internet ke through it's trying to convert it so it's going to take a lot of internet and if your internet is not stable it's going to look very shabby right Also, in your virtual background and your blurred background features, when you move too much, अगर ज्यादा movement है तो वो capture नहीं कर पाता Again, it's a green screen concept, so it's not going to capture it. So आपके fingers mix हो जाएंगे या फिर गायब हो जाएंगे they get merged in the background, and all these things could happen. But do consider it as an option if you have a background that's too cluttered or too many things going on, and there is nothing you can do about it, then you go for the blurred feature. Okay, going back to this. sorry, just give me a second. Going back to what I was saying, go for a neutral background. Next thing is beware of distractions. Jab aap kisi meeting ya training ke liye baithte hain, ensure that there are not too many things going on in the background. Jab aap khud ko unmute karenge, so if music is playing, if there's an open door and somebody walks in, that's very distracting. Right? So ensure, kabhi kabhi aisa hota hai ki aap kuch bhi nahi kar payenge. You will try your best and there will still be distractions. That's okay. But do take the effort. Do take the efforts of ensuring that you're taking this seriously and you're showing up for the meeting seriously. Right? Also, movement is something that you have to be aware of. If you have kids who are playing in the background, if there are people walking by, if there are pets in the back, that's also very distracting. So ensure when you sit, you prepare for this. Jab aapko pehle pata chal jata hai ki meeting hone wali hai or there is another session, prepare for it sometime in advance. Don't be hasty and join in later and then you're trying to make everything, you know, trying to set everything once the meeting is on. That's very distracting for you, for everybody else who's present in the meeting. And it's not fair to anybody. Imagine I'm just trying to make things, it's now movement hai ki your attention is going to be drawn to my screen and you will be more interested in what is she doing. So prepare some time in advance, take 10 minutes before you join the meeting, set everything up, check your background, check how you're looking, and then switch on your camera. It'll save you time and it'll save everyone a lot of effort. So these are the options of virtual backgrounds that are available. These are some things that you must and you mustn't do. So this is an example of a man who was taking an important meeting, clearly because he was dressed in a suit, and in walked his kid and the kid started making noise. To ensure that the kid does not create a ruckus, the mother walked in and somebody took a screenshot of it. Virtual platform se kitna easy hai na? You make one mistake and everybody just takes a screenshot and then it becomes a joke on WhatsApp or something. So just be mindful of these things. Ki aisi cheeze hoti hai, and ensure that this doesn't happen to you. Next is the blurred background feature that we already spoke about. It's really good. But ensure that you don't use it constantly. You see, like I said, the internet, it sucks too much internet. Sometimes it doesn't look that great. Next thing is, be mindful of what kind of virtual background you're using. Don't use something that's too funky or gives the vibe of a party or, you know, a vacation mood. If it's a formal training or if you're attending something that is formal, ensure that it's more neutral and not too distracting. Like in this case, I am more interested background mein kya chal raha. Like this person is there, but I'm more interested here. I can see this, I can see that. So ensure that you're not doing this. Also, this is another example. When you're picking backgrounds, choose something that goes with your attire and with the meeting, right? If it's not going with your attire, like she is wearing a collared shirt and background made as an animated home, it does not match, right? So go for a feature that will match what you're wearing and how you're appearing for that meeting. This is just to bring to your notice that virtual mishaps do happen. Doesn't mean it'll happen to everybody, but they do happen. You need to be sure. Sometimes your internet is not working. Somebody else's internet is not working. Your background is not being translated well through camera. It could be for multiple reasons. You may appear a little off. So ensure that this does not happen. This is a case where somebody was wearing a green t-shirt and it clearly merged with the background, so much so that only his head was visible. This is another example. Yahan pe the face has merged. Matlab even the face and the neck has merged. Only the clothes are visible. Okay, next is lighting and angles. First thing that you have to think about is how your angle is placed and how you're appearing on camera. You have to always go for a flattering angle. By flattering, I mean your face shouldn't appear too large or too small. Proportionate hona chahiye compared to your structure. So if my face is this much and my shoulders are here, any larger than this, my face is going to take up most of the frame. Any smaller than this, my body is going to look larger than my face. So ensure that you use a flattering angle. And don't sit, the next thing is don't sit too close to the camera, because when you do this, you're taking up too much of the frame, right? Balance nahi maintain hota, there's no proportion. So ensure that you sit at least 1.5 to 2 feet from the camera. Next thing is, if you're logging in through a phone, especially tabhi hota hai when you log in through a phone, ensure that you're keeping your phone at eye level or above. Because if it's lower than that, ye part jo hai na, wo enlarge hota hai. Like, as you can see in these pictures, it's enlarged. So it's not very appealing. It's not your best. This is not how you look, right? When this part is enlarged, that's not how you generally look. So ensure when you're logging in through phone that it's at least at eye level, that you appear proportionate on camera. Next is the lighting. First and foremost, when you sit for meetings or any virtual setup, ensure that you're facing the light source. Because if the light comes from behind, you will appear dark on camera. Right? If it comes from one side, then the other side will shadow. So ensure that you're facing the light source so that it's evenly spread out and you look healthy and lively. Next is, light should fall on your face, obviously, because if it's behind, it's going to create a silhouette and it's not very flattering, like it's shown in this picture. Next thing is, sit sun facing if your session is during the day, right? If it's for sunset, ensure that you're sitting facing the light source. Like if I do this, you can see the tube light reflection in my eyes, in my glasses, because I'm sitting in the direction of the light source. Agar main thoda bhi turn ho jau, so there will be a lot of shadows on my face. And forget you, you and everybody else in the meeting will not be able to see me. And your mind will run to things like, I can't see her. Why is the lighting so off? She's appearing dark. Things like that, which will take away the focus again from what I'm seeing to how I'm appearing. So once you have that sorted, the focus will always just be on you. Next thing is, ensure that your phone or laptop is stationary or it's mounted, right? When you log in through a phone and you're constantly moving, agar aap ek jagah se dusri jagah ja rahe ho, ya fir you're trying to adjust the angle, it's distracting. Kyunki in 40 windows, I can see that movement. So mera attention bar bar rahi ja raha hai. I'm trying to think, what is happening? So ensure that it's stationary. What you can do is, you can either try and attach your phone to one of these, which is a stand, which is a phone stand or your selfie stand or any other stands that you have. Or the best option is something that I also do. You can layer books on one top of the other and place your phone or your laptop on it so that it's stationary. So you don't have to keep moving it. Especially tab hota hai jab hum phone se log in karte ho and your hand starts paining because you're holding it. 10-15 minutes ke liye aap acche dikhte ho. 15 minutes ke baad you're like, your hand is paining. You're trying to adjust and you're trying to, you know, get a better view, and usme it becomes really distracting. Your video is shaking, your background is shaking, you're all over the place basically. So apart from all this, these are a few things that we must be careful about. First thing is, test your setup before joining. Your setup includes your lighting, your background, how you're appearing on camera, and also your audio. So ye sari cheeze before you log in, pehle test kar lijiye. After you log in, when you're saying, hello, am I audible? Hello, hello. It's really distracting and you're taking up valuable time. So be prepared, right? You know, aapko pata hai meeting hone wali hai. Pehle be prepared, and when you enter, you have everything sorted with your pen and paper, your notes, everything sorted, right? Next thing is, the minute you enter a meeting, mute yourself. Because suppose koi conversation chal raha hai and you enter and there is some background noise or there is music playing from your device, it's distracting, right? The people who were having a conversation did not now have a conversation. And they've lost what they were saying. They forgot what they were saying. And now you're the focus and not them. Ya fir, people are discussing something and you enter the meeting, it's going to disrupt. And as a mark of respect, you must mute yourself unless you're asked to unmute, unless you're asked to speak. Third thing is arrive early. Don't be late. Being fashionably late is not cool. Trust me. Because if you are late, you will miss out on something really valuable. We are all here to learn, right? Right? So if you're going to be late and you miss out, it's waste. It's a waste. So you must be on time or at least be early. Next is keep a glass of water handy. And drinking from a bottle can be a little distracting, and it can also be, if your screen freezes, it's not a good sight. Agar aap bottle, you know, you're trying to drink from the bottle and for some reason aapki screen freeze away, it's going to be a very not so pretty sight. So ensure you keep a glass of water handy so that you don't even have to switch off your video, go get that glass of water and come back. That's what I mean by being prepared. Last thing is rename yourself. Beware of what names you have kept, because it's difficult for the speaker and the host to address you. Because if your name is not your device, or something else, like Android 7 or something of that sort, how do we address you? If you don't know, you've logged in, suppose you've logged in through your colleague's device, or you've logged in through your sibling's device, and the name is different, it's going to cause a lot of confusion. Because we're trying to get your attention, but we don't know your name, and it's reading something completely different, and you're also unaware. So there's a commotion, right? Everybody's trying to search. No, you in this t-shirt, I'm talking to you. Right? So to avoid that, ensure that you rename your devices as your full name, not just your first name, your full name. This is a great example. I'm using my own example of things that I have done and have clearly not worked in my favor, and then how I've moved to working on things that actually help me look more presentable. So in this picture, in the first picture, the lighting is off. My background is too cluttered. There are too many things in the background. There is an open door here. Anybody can walk in, anybody can walk out. There's another door here. There is too much distraction, right? My face is not lit. I'm wearing something that I would wear at home. So I don't look fresh, I don't look presentable. Versus in the second picture, I have taken the effort of setting up the lighting. Because light ek taraf se aa raha hai, I've ensured that dusri taraf se bhi light gire face pe. My hair is done up, my face and my styling is in place, and then I have logged into the meeting. So you see the difference? What a difference the lighting and your background and your grooming can make. I can see a few people nod. All right, so that was about your virtual presence. Ab baat karenge powerful introduction ki. Sabse pehle tell me, what is an introduction? You can unmute yourself and tell me.
Hi, Anuja.
Hi.
Am I audible now? Okay.
Yes, you are.
So I think introduction is basically about introducing yourself, like in giving basic details about yourself, where you belong to, what's your name, how about your family members, and what currently profession are you in. So it's like basic information about yourself. And also I can add like hobbies and all if you want to add on.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Anshu. That was absolutely correct. That's exactly, everything that you said is exactly what an introduction is. It's the act of introducing yourself to others. Khud ke baare mein dusron ko kuch cheeze batana, isko hum ek introduction kehte hain. Right? So, yes, Neha, do you want to say something? Okay.
So, hello, ma'am. Sorry to interrupt you. I just wanted to say that introduction plays a major role from standing you out from other people, because everywhere, if it's every pageant or interview, even in audition, it's that introduction and the starting few minutes that decide you that whether you're going to stay or not. So I think introduction is really plays a major role.
Thank you, Akansha. Absolutely. First impression, say a lot of things can be assessed, how competent you are, how successful you are, how well versed and how talented you are, which is why like working on your virtual presence is important. Likewise, working on your introduction is equally important. So there are three components that we have to think of when we give our introductions. That's the who, the what, and the why. तो व्हाट आर दीज, लेट्स लुक इनटू दैट. हमें तीन सवाल आंसर करने हैं, तो वी डोंट हैव टू से दीज आउट लाउड, ये हमारे माइंड में होना चाहिए. द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन दैट वी हैव टू आंसर इज हु, व्हिच स्टैंड्स फॉर हु आर यू, आप कौन है, व्हाट इज योर नेम, व्हाट इज योर एज, वेयर डू यू कम फ्रॉम और वेयर आर यू करंटली डिसाइडिंग, राइट. दैट इज द, जस्ट अ सेकंड, गिव मी अ सेकंड. सबसे पहले हम क्या कहते हैं किसी को जब हम मिलते हैं, द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट यू से इज योर नेम, राइट, हु आर यू. So that's the first thing that you have to also say when you are introducing yourself, your name, your age and your place of residence or where you're currently residing or where you come from, which part of the country or which part of the world. Next, what that you have to think about is what do you do? So aap karte kya hai? Are you studying? Are you a professional? If you're a professional, so aap kya kaam kar rahe hai aur kahan kaam kar rahe hai? And if you're a student, where are you studying? What are you studying? All these things you're supposed to tell a person. Because think about it this way, जो आपके बारे में कुछ नहीं जानता उनको आप क्या क्या बताएंगे, right? First you will tell who you are and second will be what do you do. Now after that you also have to think about what are you good at, because this is a passion and here you're going to be talking about your skills and your talents. What you're good at is something that you have to focus on. So this is where you talk about what your passion is about, what your skilled at and what your talents and achievements are. And the last thing is why, your reason, why are you here, aap yahan kyun hai, why do you want to participate, why do you want to win, what is your core reason that made you click on the register now, right, that thought that made you believe that yes I can do this, I am meant for this. So what is your core reason for being here? This is all that is that encompasses an introduction. इसके अलावा ग्रीटिंग्स आर एब्सोल्युटली एब्सोल्युटली इंपॉर्टेंट. सबसे पहले तो ग्रीटिंग्स डिनोट रिस्पेक्ट फॉर अदर्स एंड दे क्रिएट अ फेवरेबल इंप्रेशन ऑफ यू ऑन एवरीबडी एल्स. सो इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू एक्नॉलेज द प्रेजेंस ऑफ पीपल. जैसे हैरी ने पहले मुझे ग्रीट किया, देन मुझे इंट्रोड्यूस किया एंड देन आई टुक ओवर द प्लेटफॉर्म एंड व्हेन आई डिड द फर्स्ट थिंग आई सेड टू ऑल वाज हेलो, राइट. So it's very important to greet everybody present because you're acknowledging that they have taken out the time to be here. So you're acknowledging their presence and you're respecting their time. Next thing is every introduction should begin and end with a greeting. It's like in a letter. Jab hum letter likhte hain, start and end mein there is a greeting. Likewise, in an introduction also, you begin with a greeting and you end with one. So your beginning greeting can be a hello, right, which is a formal way of addressing people. Hey and hi are very casual, so that's up to you if you want to use that, but for formal settings hello is the correct way. Next is your hello can be followed by good morning, good afternoon or good evening depending on the time of the day. From morning to 12 p.m. will be good morning, 12 p.m. to 6 p.m. will be good afternoon, and post that will be good evening. Good night is not a greeting, it's a send off, it's a bye, it's a goodbye, right? So it's only used when you're closing the conversation and also it's evening or it's night. So don't use good night, use good morning, afternoon or evening depending on what time of the day it is. End with a thank you. Every introduction must end with a thank you, not because you are just thanking people who are there. That's also there, wo to karna hi hai, you have to thank everyone for being present and for listening to you. Also, the thank you is a cue. It's a sign that you're telling people that you're done with your introduction. Agar aap thank you nahi bolenge and you suddenly just stop, everybody in the meeting, including the judges, the jury, the speaker, they will not know if you're finished. So there will be an awkward silence. Ho gaya aapka, baki hai. Everybody is going to wait for a few seconds because they think you still have something to say. Aur aap bhool gaye ho. So the minute you are done, the second you are done, say thank you and let everybody know that your introduction is over. Next thing is talent and skills. speak about your talent and skills. It's very, very important, especially abhi, kyunki you've taken part in a pageant. So yahan pe aapke skills, your talent, what you're good at really, really matters. So speak about them. Speak passionately about them. What do you like to do? What are you good at? Mention your previous wins. Agar aap koi kisi cheez mein aapne participate kiya tha, uska participation ka proof hai, aapke paas certificate hai, ya aapne kisi competition mein hissa liya tha jo aap jeete hain. Talk about these things because these are your achievements. These are your wins. This is something that you, this is something you're proud of and you would like the other people to know about you, right? So do mention these are important. Next is showcase your skills. अगर आपकी कोई ऐसी स्किल है जो दिखाई जा सकती है, सिंगिंग है, डांसिंग है, प्लेइंग द इंस्ट्रूमेंट, मे बी अ गिटार, अ पियानो, एनीथिंग, अगर वो शोकेस की जा सकती है, बाय ऑल मींस लेट देम सी इट. अगर ये फिजिकली होता, यू वुड हैव टेकन द एफर्ट, राइट? सो लाइकवाइज वर्चुअली ऑल्सो, व्हाइल यू गिव योर इंट्रोडक्शन, यू हैव टू शोकेस व्हाट यू आर गुड एट. नेक्स्ट थिंग इज, अभी देयर आर टैलेंट्स दैट यू कांट शोकेस. अब आप बोलोगे आई एम गुड एट कुकिंग, हाउ डू आई शोकेस? You can't showcase cooking skills, right? So you, what you can do is use pictures or use other references that can show that you're good at something or that's something you like to do, right? Certificates, trophies, photographs, ho sakte hai, keep them handy. Don't go looking for them while you're introducing yourself, right? Next thing is be mindful of the camera placement and camera angle when you're showcasing your talent. So for example, agar aap dance kar rahe hain and you leave the camera there, you go behind and you start dancing, kabhi kabhi because of the camera angle aapka face dikhai nahi deta, we can only see neck down, so we can't see what expressions you're giving, we cannot see your hand movement. So ensure that when you're doing this, you have rehearsed beforehand. Aapne pehle camera mein dekha hai how you're appearing, what is the distance, are you completely visible through the camera? If you're not sure, practice it with a video. Take a video of yourself, see how you're appearing. Maybe look in the mirror. Agar samne ki taraf mirror hai, dekhiye how it's appearing in your camera. So on and so forth. Next thing is timing. Timing is really, really important. Everybody will be given 90 seconds to give their introductions, and you make sure that everything that you have to say is within those 90 seconds. Because if you're going to exceed, you're straining everybody's attention. The rule of 90 seconds is in place for a reason, right? So ensure that everything that you have to say is done in 90 seconds. Great introductions are crisp and to the point. So if you're going to exceed the time limit just because you have so many things to say, it's going to be a little difficult to keep up, right? Because you're trained, every mind is trained to come into the meeting saying, okay, everybody has 90 seconds. If you're going to go on for 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 5 minutes, you're just straining everybody's attention. It's difficult to keep up. Kya 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 bol rahe hai? I lost count. 5 minutes, if you're saying so many things that you're good at, I've lost count. So ensure that you're timing your introductions really well and that your introduction is within 90 seconds. Next thing is rehearse with a timer and try not to exceed the limit. What you can do is with your phones or your laptop, we have timers available. So when you rehearse, baar baar dekhiye kitna time lag raha hai. अगर ज्यादा हो रहा है तो रिमूव समथिंग दैट इज नॉट नीडेड, ओनली पुट इन थिंग्स दैट आर रेलेवेंट एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट. डोंट पुट एवरीथिंग. नेक्स्ट थिंग इज डोंट पुट एवरीथिंग इन द इंट्रोडक्शन. दिस इज एन इंट्रोडक्शन, इट्स नॉट एन एसे अबाउट आवरसेल्फ, राइट? सो सब चीजें नहीं आएगी. यू डोंट हैव टू पुट एवरीथिंग अंडर द सन. यू हैव टू ओनली पुट दोज थिंग्स दैट विल पॉजिटिवली रिफ्लेक्ट हु यू आर एज अ पर्सन एंड व्हाट आर सम ऑफ द थिंग्स यू आर गुड एट. नेक्स्ट थिंग इज डोंट रिपीट द सेम पॉइंट. अगर आपने पहले कुछ डिस्कस किया है, अगेन 2 मिनट के बाद यू कम बैक टू इट एंड से द सेम थिंग अगेन, इट्स गोइंग टू जस्ट टेक अप वैल्यूएबल टाइम, राइट? एंड नॉट ऐड वैल्यू, क्योंकि आपने पहले भी वो डिस्कस कर दिया है. सो एंश्योर दैट यू आर नॉट डूइंग दिस. नाउ वी टॉक अबाउट वॉइस एंड बॉडी लैंग्वेज. सो इंट्रोडक्शन में इट्स नॉट जस्ट व्हाट यू आर सेइंग, इट्स ऑल्सो हाउ यू आर सेइंग इट दैट क्रिएट्स एन इंप्रेशन अबाउट यू, राइट? So first and foremost is your tone. How are you saying what you're saying? Agar aap jo emotion that you're using behind the words is not a positive one, or is a very neutral one, or a very dull one, it's not going to be interesting. Your introduction won't end up being interesting. So the tone that you're using, your tone is basically your emotion behind your words. So when you're saying you're passionate about dancing, is it appearing like you're passionate? What is your tone? What is your emotion? What are you feeling? That should also be apparent when somebody sees you and somebody hears you. Next thing is your pitch. Pitch is your volume. Ensure that it's at a medium pitch. You know, you have maintained a medium pitch. Don't be too soft, because when you're really soft, log aapko sun nahi payenge. So if I'm just speaking like this, that you have to maintain a good tone, a good pitch. You cannot hear me. The first thing you're going to do is, we can't hear you, right? So don't be too mellow, don't be too soft, but also don't be too loud. Being too loud can be really overwhelming and daunting for the people who are already in the meeting. So maintain a medium tone, a medium pitch. Next thing is, give an eye contact when you're introducing yourself. Like I said, how do you do that? You occasionally look in the camera. Don't constantly stare, but don't look away also. Eye contact denotes your confidence. It denotes how well you know yourself and how well you know where you're going, right? Next thing is smile. When you smile, naturally your personality becomes more approachable, becomes more friendly, and that is somebody who you would like to know, right? If you're not smiling, it will appear like you're too serious and you're not enjoying what you're seeing. So if I'm just talking like this, I love dancing and I have been learning dancing since I was 12 years old and I have won 3 trophies. This creates a barrier. When you smile, it breaks those barriers and people come closer. You create a rapport with people, right? You connect to people. So do smile. And of course, by smiling, it really lights up your face, brings out your best features. Trust me, everybody has a great smile. So do smile when you give your introduction. Next thing is, use your hands wherever required. It adds a personal touch. If you all have noticed so far, I have been using my hands. I cannot talk without using my hands. I cannot sit like this and say, this is what it is and this is what it's not, right? So use your hands. It adds a personal touch, especially when you're passionate about something and you're talking with it with all your heart. So you say, I absolutely love dancing. It just lights up my day. So you see how your body language is connected to what you're saying. And because it's more expressive, you relate to it more. So use your hands wherever required. However, don't overdo it. Next is appear confident. The way you're going to appear is the way you're going to feel. And that's exactly what other people are going to pick on, right? So agar aap confident appear karenge, that's exactly how people will look at you. Oh, she's so confident. Oh, she knows who she is and where she's going, what she's doing. She's just so... her self-esteem is so good. Those are the thoughts you think about that person, right? Versus when somebody who's not confident, you're going to think, oh, maybe she's nervous. Maybe she's having a long day. Maybe she's had a long day. Maybe there are too many things in her mind. So appear confident. Next thing is, be aware of your posture. Really, really important. If you're going to be slouched, or if your shoulders are drooped, or your chin is too high or too low, it's going to look weird on camera also, and plus your impression will also be made according to how you're looking. So ensure that your posture is correct. By correct posture, I mean your shoulders have to be squared. They don't have to be drooping, they don't have to be too high, they have to be squared, so which means they have to be in line with your shoulder line, right? And they have to be relaxed. You can't be tensed up. Don't tense up your muscles. Look relax, be relaxed. And your chest should be slightly high. Don't sink in, right? So don't hunch. It should be slightly high and your chin up. Now, not too up, not too down, just right. When you give an eye contact, hum kaise maintain karte hain? That way. All right? Now, let's look at some do's and don'ts. Kya cheeze hai jo hume karni chahiye aur kya cheeze hai hume nahi karni chahiye, right? First and foremost, do talk about your passions and skills, because they will add to who you are, right? When somebody gets to know you, when you add something that you love or something that you're good at, people immediately connect to you. So do talk about your passions and skills. Next thing is, do keep it brief. Do keep it short and concise, to the point. Don't mention 3-4 sentences about the same topic or the same point. Whatever's needed, utna hi baat kijiye. Don't exceed. Next thing is, do prepare in advance. Write down your introductions if it's needed. Rehearse them out loud. Rehearse them on video, on camera. see how you're looking, check how you're appearing, how are you sounding? Are you sounding confident? Are you sounding nervous? How are you sounding? So ये सब तभी होगा when you rehearse, right? अगर आप rehearse नहीं करेंगे आपको पता नहीं चलेगा कि क्या करना चाहिए था क्या नहीं करना चाहिए था. And after your introduction is over, you will be thinking, अरे ये तो मैंने बात ही नहीं किया, ये तो मैंने बताया ही नहीं, I forgot to mention this, I forgot to mention that. So instead of that, rehearse, be prepared, prepare in advance and then appear for your round. Next is do highlight key points. अगर आपके बारे में there is something that you want the jury and the judges to know, mention that, highlight that. Don't leave it for the last, क्योंकि अगर आप last के लिए छोड़ेंगे and if for some reason you exceeded the time limit, you're going to miss out. So ensure that whatever is needed, whatever is required, things that you want the people to know, highlight those points in the beginning itself. Next thing is keep a still frame as far as possible. A moving frame can be distracting. This, like we have discussed in your virtual presence, jitna aapki frame move hogi, jitna your camera will move, like this is moving, it's distracting. So jitna stable rahega, utna the attention will be on you. Right? Now, what are some of the don'ts? Kaun si cheez hai jo hame nahi karni chahiye? First and foremost, don't use too many fancy words unnecessarily. Don't try to impress someone, is what I mean to say. Right? So if there are some words that correctly describe what you want to say, by all means, use them. But don't use too many fancy words. Right? That's going to create an impression that you're trying too hard. Next thing is, don't use too many gestures. Like I said, it can be distracting for people. So don't use too many, but use them wherever you have to, wherever you really need to express. Next thing is, don't talk about your family members in depth unless you're asked to. You are here for your round. You are participating in the pageant, not your family. With all due respect to them, when people want to get to know them, they will ask. But jab tak aapko pucha na jaye, don't focus on your family and your siblings. Focus on you. This is your introduction. This should be about you. And plus, given the 90 seconds, you should ensure that everything that you have to speak about is covered. So don't speak about your family. You can mention it, but don't talk too much about it. Unless aapko kisi ne sawal pucha ya aapko bola elaborate kijiye on your family. Right? Unless that happens, don't do it. Next thing is, avoid using fillers. So fillers are words that we use when we are thinking or we are trying to recollect. So those are the words that we use between two words. For example, if I'm unable to recollect a word, I will be like, that thing. So I went there and so these are fillers. So ensure that you're not using too many of them. This will only happen if you rehearse beforehand. If you know what you're going to say, tabhi ye fillers aapke mind mein nahi aayenge, because you won't be trying to recollect words. They will be at your disposal. Next thing is, don't keep fidgeting. It's very, very distracting. By fidgeting, I mean any kind of a repetitive movement. For example, if you're playing with your hair constantly, you're constantly checking your glasses, you're constantly touching your nose, you're constantly touching your face. Any repetitive behavior that we call as fidgeting can be distracting. So when you're giving your introductions, when you're appearing for these rounds, ensure that you're not behaving or repeating these behaviors. Next thing is, instead of these statements, try these statements. So for example, instead of saying, I'm doing my degree from University of Mumbai or Mumbai University, you can say, I'm pursuing my degree from Mumbai University, right? That's a more appropriate way of saying it, because degree jo hoti hai, hum usko pursue karte hai. It's not a thing that you do. So when you're speaking about that, be mindful and you can go for an alternative like pursuing my degree. Next is, when you're talking about your age, don't say, I am 22 years old. You can just say, I'm 22 and I live in Mumbai. When you say 22 years old, it's a very old way of saying. It's a very ancient way of expressing yourself. The new way and the more apt way is just saying the numbers. Aapko years old bolne ki zarurat nahi hai. It will be understood that you're talking about your age. Next thing is, instead of saying, I'm doing a job at HDFC Bank, instead of that, you can say, I work I am working at HDFC Bank. Instead of saying my designation or my job title is branch manager, you can say I work as a branch manager at HDFC Bank, right? Instead of saying I live in Mumbai, you could just say I reside in Mumbai or I'm from Mumbai. It's just a different way of saying it. Next thing is, instead of saying I'm also good at sketching, painting and mandala art, instead of that, you can also say additionally, I'm also a talented artist and I also like mandala art and sketching and painting, so on and so forth. Right? These are just some ideas. These are not rules. Aisa nahi hai ki aisa hi bolna hai aur aisa nahi bolna hai. It's just to give you an idea of how creative you can be with the words that you use. Next, some tips to note. First and foremost, be you and let your personality shine. As much as we like actresses, as much as we all love Kareena Kapoor and Priyanka Chopra, don't try to be them because you are unique. Try to be you, and let your personality shine. We are all unique. So we all have different things to bring to the table, different things to share, different ideas to give. So be you and let the person and let everybody in the meeting get to know the real you. Right? Next thing is emphasize on your positive qualities. If there is something about you that you really admire, talk about that, because when you showcase your or talk about your positive qualities, people want to get to know you more, right? So if there is something that you want people to know, talk about it. Next thing is your attitude matters. It matters a lot because what attitude and what mindset you come to give your introduction with is going to determine how you appear and how people see you. So agar aapka attitude hai, I've had a long day, I'm tired, I'm just here to give the introduction and go, aur bhi kaam hai, I'm very preoccupied, that's exactly how you're going to appear and that's exactly how people will look at you. Versus if you're coming with a can-do attitude and you're really excited, that excitement will be translated through the camera and that's what people are going to catch on. Next thing is work a little on your communication skills. If you feel like that's something that makes you a little stressful or something that makes you nervous, work a little on it. Google it. We have so many tools available. Google something that you're unsure of. You can get in touch with me. You can get in touch with any of us or with Harry. You can reach us personally and we will help you if you are stuck. It's not a must. It's if you are stuck and if you want to work on it and enhance it, then that is something you must do beforehand, before your introductory round. Next thing is language shouldn't be a barrier. Language is just a way we express ourselves, right? It's just a common ground. Ki main jo kehna chahti hu, aapko samajh raha hai, that's all that language is, right? So don't make it, don't have this block in your head that English mein hi baat karna hai. And, you know, you're stressing yourself out. And during the introduction, you're fumbling because you're trying to say so many things in different ways. So what will happen is you'll come across as nervous. That may not be the case, but you'll come across as nervous. So don't let your language be a barrier. If you're comfortable in Hindi, just announce beforehand ki aap Hindi mein baat karne wale ho and then continue in Hindi, right? Don't think of language as something that should hold you back, right? Next thing is make sure you are clear when you speak. By clear, I mean, you need to enunciate your words correctly. You need to pronounce your words correctly. Because when you're virtually saying something, it has to be audible clearly to people in the meeting, right? If you're speaking in a muffled voice or you're speaking under your breath, for example, hello everyone, I'm Anuja, I'm from Mumbai. I am speaking under my breath. This is a muffled voice, which means you can't hear me clearly. So you're going to strain your ears. You're going to ask, Anuja, I can't hear you. Can you please be louder? Right? So be mindful. And when you're speaking, speak clearly. Pronounce the words clearly so that there is nothing that can be misinterpreted. Kabhi kabhi hum words ka, you know, sometimes when you mispronounce or you're speaking in a lower tone, aap bologe kuch aur, sunai dega kuch aur. Right? Car, care, words could get mixed up. So ensure that you're speaking clearly. All right. So that's all from my end. Thank you so much for listening patiently. And now I will take up any questions or queries that you all may have. Yes, Sushmita. I can see your hand raised. Do you have a question?
Ma'am.
Hi.
Hello, ma'am. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm good. मैम
पूरा
क्लियर है, कोई डाउट नहीं है, कोई क्वेश्चन नहीं है.
All right, thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Does anybody else have a doubt or something that they want me to be?
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah, hi, Akansha. Tell me.
Yeah, I was about to say that you said like for some skills, you said like cooking and like other painting, and you're supposed to show pictures. Like, how will I like include those things in my introduction? Like, as if I said like I'm good at painting, sketching, how would I showcase that? Like, I didn't get that.
If you have a picture that you've sketched or you've painted, you can just showcase that in front of the camera. Or if you have a picture of it, अगर फोटोग्राफ है आपके फोन में तो आप फोन दिखा सकते हैं. Alright, don't miss out on an opportunity just because how will you showcase? Yeah, you know, this is a very big painting. How do I showcase in front of the camera? Don't think of those things. It's a painting you have made with your efforts. So do showcase it. That is something we would like to see. Right, the jury would like to see that.
Okay, anybody else has a question? Great, I think we are good to go. So thank you so much, Anuja. Thank you. I think somebody has just complimented you for the session. So thank you so much. It's always a pleasure listening to you. And you know, I'm really looking forward to what we have to do further. So thank you so much. I shall take your leave and have a word with the participants.
Thank you so much, Harry. It's an absolute pleasure to be here. Wishing you all the best, ladies. And thank you so much for the wonderful comments. Thank you. Have a great day.